Anisha, I heard one of the questions one from an English colleague, and I was surprised to hear that. And she said, "Aren't you guys forbidden to cross the sea and come and live in this country?" So I've heard that from my forefathers, maybe. They were saying that it's not allowed to समुद्र पार करना पाप है. तो आई डोंट नो व्हाट द बैकग्राउंड इज. आई डोंट थिंक एनी गॉस्पेल विल आवर वेदास विल प्रिस्क्राइब दैट सॉर्ट ऑफ रिस्ट्रिक्शन. सो कैन यू पुट सम लाइट ऑन दैट एंड व्हाई पीपल आर आस्किंग दैट दिस सॉर्ट ऑफ फनी क्वेश्चन.
Satya ji, the reason why these people are asking you this such funny questions because they don't want you to be here. They want to send you back home. They'll even buy you a ticket now. You know, there are some politicians offering a ticket to send you back home. So don't listen to them too much. Okay, let me tell the serious part. The beautiful Vedic scriptures were very open-minded. They were never restrictive. But what we did is this. The spiritual freedom the ancient Hindus, you know, kind of enjoyed is not seen anywhere in the world. That's why even it's a pluralistic pathway, many ways to explore spirituality. This is the breadth of this marvelous tradition. But with that marvelous, if you like, the openness in the spiritual realm, we were very restrictive in the social realm. We're very restrictive. So you have this horrendous caste system. You can't, you know, marry somebody else. You can't even hear the Vedas if you're in the lower caste. So the marvelous spiritual power, if like the breadth of vision, was severely compromised in the at the social level. Seriously compromised. We are very poor. In the West, they have spirit, if they have good, if you like, a social democracy, but no freedom in spiritual thinking. They are restricted. They must follow the Church of England, otherwise they are doomed. In India, you can have your own spiritual pathway. You can create your own pathway. Tremendous openness in the spiritual realm, but very restrictive in the social realm. Here, in society, tremendous freedom. So if you like, this is how the two civilizations have moved on. Tremendous freedom in the social realm, tremendous freedom in the spiritual realm. Now, because of this very restrictive social phenomena that we inherited, in those days, they said, in order for us to keep our purity, look, the same old thing that you'll find in every civilization. In order to be very pure, let us not get mixed up with people from outside. So even when people from outside came in, they were called malech, means they were, you know, kind of intruders. They were villains. They were considered to be outcasts, worse than outcasts even. So we were kind of very restrictive socially, saying that nobody can come and mix with us. We are very special. We are chosen people. And these are outsiders. Barbarians is the word we used for them. And at the same time, if they are barbarians, surely we can't go into their land. We'll become barbarians too. So we can't move outside. So we just put, if you like, a border across India. You can't go out. Don't let the outsiders come in, and you don't go out either. This was the very restrictive social realm that we inherited. So this is how this idea of, you know, going across the ocean was forbidden. It was forbidden. You know, there's a story about one Brahmin who was taken by Alexander outside India, and he said, "Oh, help me out," and he killed himself. Yeah, there's a story. So we were very restrictive, very, very strict regarding where we move. Now, look, that is, if you like, the past. Do you know what comes with Swami Vivekananda, which is very touching? He said, "This is the time, this is the reason why India fell down, collapsed." You see, when you don't have interaction with the rest of the reality, the rest of this world, if you try and become restrictive, you soon begin to stink. Just like a pool of water that is not allowed to flow will begin to stink. In the same way, when the Indians put this border around it, we don't want to mix with others and others cannot come in, we paid a heavy price. We became a stagnant civilization, stagnant. So any little bacteria can, because it's like saying, "Oh, your child cannot leave the house, otherwise you'll get disease." Okay, you keep the child here, his immunity is down. He goes out and catches the flu and he'll die in 2 minutes. So the moment the Westerners came, we died as a civilization because the immunity was gone. We didn't know how to interact with the outsiders because we were told not to interact. And they just intruded and we didn't know what to do. And we fell at their feet and became slaves for thousands of years, for 1,000 years. So if you like, this restrictive thing that we put on our society created, if you like, tremendous problem for India for 1,000 years. I'm telling you, this is reality. And this is Swami Vivekananda saying, he said, the moment India put this boundary saying, we don't interact with outsiders, that was the death knell of the civilization. It's going to go down. It's going to stagnate and pay a heavy price. That's what we have paid.